Hi, everyone. My name is Fernando Anjos. I'm the guy in bold over there. I'm a financial economist, so José Tavares was talking about that boat a while ago. I mean, a financial economist is definitely the guy who's going to come out of the boat, even a worse reputation than macroeconomists these days after the crisis. I did my PhD at Carnegie Mellon University, and for the last 6 years, I've been a finance professor at the University of Texas at Austin, and I decided to return this year, and so I joined Nova in September. And in the fall semester, I was teaching the core investments course of the Masters in Finance program. My research is mostly in corporate finance, and I have, I mean, a few pieces that touch upon the topic of risk management and derivatives. And so this course is largely based on the course I taught for the last few years at the University of Texas at Austin in the MBA program. And what is it? What is it about? Let me give you a little bit of a motivation for the course. Risk management matters, right? If you're running a company and if you take on too much risk, then multiple bad things can happen, right? If your customers or your employees or even suppliers perceive that that you are going to fail, that you possibly are going to go bankrupt, possibly you are going to lose a lot of business, right? These are the so-called financial distress costs. In addition to that, if you don't keep a strong financial position, you may be predated by a competitor. So there's a strategic aspect to managing risk, right? And then finally, if you don't manage your liquidity, so if you don't make sure that your internal cash flows are high enough, you may have to pass up a lot of profitable investment opportunities. So that's yet another reason to think about risk management. So what do we do in this course? Obviously, almost any decision in management has a risk dimension to it, and that would be too broad of a scope in terms of a risk management course. So what we focus is on the management of financial risk. So risk associated, cash flow risk associated with the fluctuation of exogenous financial prices like the price of oil or currencies, exchange rates, interest rates. And we focus on how we can use derivative securities like forward contracts, futures, swaps, options. How can we use these securities to manage risk effectively? Good. So in terms of specifically, what do we do in the course? There's kind of two blocks of things, or I like to organize this in this dichotomy. First, I would like us to understand what the economics of risk management, right? So we'll introduce a few key concepts of risk management in class, discuss simple examples that help us understand what risk management is all about. And then having these tools, we'll start, for instance, looking at what happens in the real world, say the crash in oil prices that is affecting energy companies quite a lot, right? So if you look at the shale energy sector in the US, and with this plummeting in oil prices, a lot of companies are very close to bankruptcy, and you see huge decreases in planned capital expenditures for the next few years. So how could risk management have helped companies, you know, navigate these hard times? What happened to companies who did engage in risk management versus companies who did not engage in risk management? This is the kind of topic that, for instance, we will go over in class. There's more strategic aspects to risk management. For instance, you look at a market like airlines, you will notice that, I mean, Delta, for instance, was using a lot of hedging, while American Airlines was not using hedging at all. Does this make sense? Why might some companies choose to hedge while others are not hedging? And what are the strategic aspects of this game? Let's call it like that. So this is kind of one block of the material, and the corollary of which will be the preparation and discussion in class of case studies. So we'll do a few case studies related to the risk management topic in class. In addition to this, one of the things that we also do in this course, and this is where the course is a little bit nerdy, let's put it like that, is we'll try to have like kind of a very clear understanding of how derivative securities work and how they are priced, okay? And I think this is a fundamental aspect of getting managers to actually engage in derivatives-based risk management in practice. If you look at manager surveys, the most comprehensive management surveys that are out there, a lot of the reasons why some managers do not use derivatives to manage risk is because they feel they don't understand them, okay? That's a commonly cited reason for people not using derivatives to manage risk. And so I think that If during this course we get a good handle on how these securities work, there's a better chance of understanding how they can create value and be part of your overall corporate strategy. Okay. So in terms of grading, so there will be the case studies, and class participation will also account for 20%, and we will have a final exam which will account for 40%. And yep, that's basically it. Thank you.